Was written in 1967, and that's what it was. The title was a description of how it felt to be in New York City with no money, from time to time driving a cab, a taxi, and the music also, you know, the theme that came from it, came from those feelings at that time, lean years. That's what it was about, and that's where it came from.
How long did it take you to write that tune, Lean Years?
3 seconds. 3 seconds. To physically capture it and photograph it took a number of years to learn how to write music. But the composition, it emerged immediately as an idea on the instrument that felt good, that sounded good. And now I wanted others to play with so that we can play that theme. And I didn't know how to write at that time. I didn't know how to read music either because I was self-taught.
In 1979, at the age of 34, when he was kind of at the top of his game as a really dominant figure in jazz guitar, Pat had a near-fatal cerebral hemorrhage, a burst of blood vessels deep in the left side of his brain that almost killed him. The operation that saved his life had to remove almost his entire left temporal lobe. This is a part of the brain that is, for most of us, essential for speech, and it's very important for music. The fact that Pat is sitting here tonight and that in a half an hour or so he's going to play a set with the same drive and ferocity for which he was known in the 70s is really a kind of a medical miracle and a mystery.
Jazz is not a type of music. Jazz is improvisation. Improvisation can take place when I open the front door and go out and choose a different direction instead of what I normally would do. Just for a change, I may improvise. I may improvise in what I have to say and all of the selective approaches to the same idea, to present an idea in a different way. So I, you know, when I'm working with serious students, I try to free them from their encasement or imprisonment in the craft. Because craftsmanship, in many cases, you'll have an individual who masters and could be virtuosic in the process, but a person who masters a craft to such a degree that they're extremely successful over elongated periods of time, and they have a career. Well, that career is separate from what they do when they come back from work, which is the norm. That's not true improvisation. That's not true jazz. There's a division. There's the work day and the day off. There's the weekend and the work week. Jazz is not that way. Music, an artist is different than a craftsman. A craftsman is someone who has mastered the craft and in a lucrative way can explore that for all of its options and opportunities. An artist is someone who has no choice. He or she has become the art in which they represent and project through their presence. The art, the ecstasy of improvisation doesn't come from the craft. It comes from a free space, a suspension. And that's what takes place when improvisation is in the process. The one thing that I've noticed by being interested in that space is what surrounds it. The space itself is a space of suspension, and the only thing that's concrete is the subject that is being focused upon. When I do that, I notice something that is continuously in play, and that's polarity. Polarity. There are always the opposites. The state itself comes from meditation, where the production of Om and the vibration of it over a longer period of time creates a state of mind that is almost like rubber. It takes shapes that it's led into. Thank you. A lot of titles are spontaneous. The moment they come out, it's because that's the state of mind you're in at the moment, you know. And at the same time, Inside Out provokes a feeling as to, wow, I wonder what he meant when he said that, when he wrote that. And that's the nature of your question. These are feelings that have something to do with exposure to certain forms of art that indent a feeling upon you. And a good example, earlier, my exposure to band leaders like Art Blakey and Horace Silver, big band writers like Gerald Wilson and Don Ellis, and many others, you know, Woody Herman, of course, Gil Evans. That particular song, Inside Out, had a feeling that was very similar, especially with horns, with a couple of horn players, very similar to those years of my exposure to Art Blakey and the Messengers and Horace Silver. And that is also one of the reasons why Inside Out, as a title, fit the melody, because these were feelings on the inside that finally have been portrayed in this composition that is similar to that era. It's a state of mind that really embodies a time that was very effective in terms of my growth as a young player. Thank you.
Thank you.
And what we're going to do is just so lucky that we're going to be more.